वेलकम बैक टू द संडे ब्रंच. और अगर आपने अभी अभी ट्यून इन किया है, काफ़ी सारे सेगमेंट्स हमारे हो चुके हैं. शुरुआत की थी मेकअप सेगमेंट से, फिर हाउस होल्ड टिप्स पर हम गए. उसके बाद हमारे साथ अलीना थी जिन्होंने हमें फिटनेस टिप्स दी, एंड उसके बाद पीएसए शो के बारे में बात करने के लिए खुर्रम और सोहा थे. और अब चलते हैं डॉक्टर शुमाल के पास, जो हमारे लिए हर हफ्ते कुछ इन्फॉर्मेशन लेकर आते हैं, बहुत ज़बरदस्त इन्फॉर्मेशन लेकर आते हैं किसी एक मर्ज के बारे में. इस वीक किस के बारे में बात करते हैं, लेट्स आस्क डॉक्टर शुमाल. हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड आफ्टरनून एक्चुअली.
गुड आफ्टरनून हुमा.
सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर टाइम. तो डॉक्टर शुमाल, आज इस वीक हम बात करने वाले हैं ब्रेन ट्यूमर के बारे में. सो शुरुआत आप करें, आप बताएं लोगों को हाउ कैसे डेवलप हो जाता है और क्या क्या सिम्टम्स होते हैं.
सो ब्रेन ट्यूमर्स, वन थिंग आई वुड लाइक टू से दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम व्हेन अ ट्यूमर इज डायग्नोज्ड इन द ब्रेन, इट्स यूजुअली कमिंग फ्रॉम समवेयर एल्स.
ओह.
सो सम इट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम अनदर ऑर्गन ऑफ द बॉडी सच एज लंग कैंसर और ब्रेस्ट कैंसर, एंड देन स्प्रेड्स टू द ब्रेन. We call these secondary tumors, secondary brain tumors. So start from somewhere else and goes into the brain. When we talk about primary brain tumors, which means that the cancer or tumor starts inside the brain, we're going to focus more on that, on those kind of tumors.
In today's segment.
Yes, in today's
segment. So this is really something which I didn't know. So initially, jo logo ko bhi nahi shayad pata hai ki ट्यूमर जो है हमेशा अक्सर जो है किसी और जगह से शुरू होकर फिर ब्रेन तक पहुंचता है. बट अगर इफ़ इट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम द ब्रेन इज कॉल्ड ब्रेन
प्राइमरी ब्रेन ट्यूमर. सो जस्ट लाइक एनी अदर ट्यूमर इन द बॉडी, इट कैन बी बेनाइन और कैंसरस. बेनाइन मीन्स इट्स नॉट कैंसरस, बट इट कैन इंक्रीज इन दिस साइज एंड कैन ग्रो एंड कैन कॉज सिम्टम्स. द कैंसरस ट्यूमर्स, वी गोना फोकस मोर ऑन दोज काइंड ऑफ ट्यूमर्स. About 23,000 new cases of brain cancer will be diagnosed or expected to be diagnosed in US this year. 23,000. Wow. And about 13,000. These primary brain tumors are a little bit more common in men for some reason. About 13,000 in men and 10,000 plus in women. And these are not very common tumors. Primary brain tumors are rare cancers. So incidence is less than, the chance of having, for someone to have brain cancer, primary brain cancer in a lifetime is less than 1%.
Oh, oh.
About 0.6, 0.7%. The common symptoms are either headaches, nausea, vomiting. Those are non-specific symptoms. But since brain is a very complex and very delicate organ.
Right.
It's covered with skull. Then there are two right and left sides of the brain. It's a very kind of like a soft tissue, soft kind of tissue. And then there are coverings, delicate coverings around the brain and spinal cord. We call those meninges. So symptoms develop based on what part of the brain is involved. Brain controls all vital organs of the body, including speech, vision, sensations, motor function, balance. So it depends on what part of the brain is involved, and the symptoms can be based on what part of that particular brain area is involved with the cancer.
Yeah, so like you said, early symptoms. Kaise spot kiye jaye early symptoms, and what are symptoms?
If it's a very small tumor, it may be completely asymptomatic. Early symptoms could be headaches. I mean, we all get headaches once in a while.
Yeah, right.
But any headaches that are not going away, persistent headaches. Often patients have migraines. Migraines happen for a few days and disappear. But persistent symptoms, unusual symptoms, different sort of headaches should make us do more workup. So headaches, if there is a tumor in the brain, it can cause swelling and inflammation of that part of the brain. And since brain is covered with skull, there's not a whole lot to expand, for the brain to expand.
Right.
And that's why even mild inflammation in the brain can cause significant amount of symptoms pretty rapidly, such as nausea, vomiting, and also, like I said, based on
loss of balance and
it can depending on the what part of the brain is involved.
Okay, so what are the different kinds or types of brain tumors?
So, like I said, most common tumors are those tumors that start from different organ and spread to the brain.
Mm-hmm.
Those are the most common. But and then the primary brain tumors could be cancerous and non-cancerous. Mm-hmm. Non-cancerous tumors cause symptoms by local expansion in the size and pressure effects. The cancerous tumor are also various subtypes. And I'm not going to go into details, but it's primarily the how aggressive these cancer seem to be under the microscope, mm-hmm. and we call it grade. How aggressive those cancers look
it's
like
called
under the
grade?
Grading, yes.
Ah, okay.
So it's not typical staging system that we use for other cancers
other
in the body. Brain tumors are mostly categorized based on what they look like under the microscope and how aggressive they look like.
So what is the grading system? Okay, a grade is like 1, 2, 3, 4?
It's like a grade 1, 2, 3, 4. Uh-huh. Grade 1 are kind of like a less aggressive-looking mm-hmm. tumors. Grade 4 are more aggressive-looking tumors. And 2 and 3 is in between.
2 and 3, so just like the stages, I say grades. Mm-hmm. So how, do certain type of cancers have different outcomes? Like alag alag jo kism ke cancers ya tumors hai, uske alag alag outcomes hote hain?
Yeah, absolutely. Less aggressive tumors generally have better outcomes, and more aggressive tumor like a grade 4, one of the common one is the GBM. We call this particular tumor GBM.
Hmm.
John McCain was diagnosed with GBM. That's a grade 4.
Mm-hmm.
Brain cancer, pretty aggressive. So it depends on that. How aggressive the tumor looks like. Generally speaking, brain tumors are more aggressive in older age group, and also those who have other medical problems, other comorbid conditions, and also there are certain molecular aspects in the cancer cells that we can detect, and that aggressiveness of the cancer also depends on some of those molecular studies we perform in the cancer cells.
So how is like, jaise hum har kism ki cancer ke liye kehte hain ki possibly your lifestyle or possibly smoking, yeah, to koi ek wajah ho sakti hai jiski wajah se ye develop ho jate hain?
Not necessarily from lifestyle. There has not been a strong correlation with the lifestyle and development of the primary brain tumors. There's no
correlation to smoking or anything as
but,
such.
But there are genetic factors, though. Mm. There are certain hereditary conditions.
So it can run in families?
Yes, it can run in the families. Mm-hmm. It can run in the families. And how we suspect whether this particular brain tumor in one patient has anything to do with the familial predisposition is by asking family history.
Hmm.
So if there are other types of cancers like leukemias, breast cancer, adrenal cancer, some nerve tumors. Mm-hmm. Tumors can arise from any part of the body. So tumors arising from nerve tissues, tumor arising inside the ear, colon cancer. So there are various hereditary conditions that are associated with primary brain cancers, and the patients should discuss with their oncologist if there is a family history of other cancers as well.
So, like we always keep saying about how to detect and early screenings and stuff like that to detect or figure out if there's any development of cancer. So for this thing, is there any kind of screenings? Is there any kind of precautions that someone can take?
So if it's there's no good screening available for primary brain cancers. First of all, these are rare,
mm-hmm.
and it's not cost effective to perform routine screening. But in some of those patients who have hereditary predisposition, sometimes we do routine screening MRIs,
mm-hmm.
if we suspect there is a high chance of a particular patient to develop primary brain cancer. But routine screening is not available and is not recommended unless there are any symptoms like we were discussing earlier.
Yeah.
how it is diagnosed. So if there is any unusual symptom, like persistent headaches, change in vision, blurry vision, new onset of seizures, some weakness or numbness in one or the other part of the body, which is unusual, should trigger imaging study. And generally speaking, CT scan or MRI needs to be done to find whether there is a tumor developing or not. And that's how we diagnose. And how do we tell what subtype it is? Then, of course, biopsy needs to be done, just like other cancers we discussed, that for definitive diagnosis and to find what exact subtype and what grade of the cancer is, we have to perform biopsy.
Like, but you said since it is rare, to log jo hai regular screening se bhi nahi pata chalta hai. And since just because of the rarity, it becomes really difficult to go for regular screenings and stuff like that. But symptoms bhi jaise aapne bataye are very
it can be vague.
It can be vague. So koi definitive tarika hota hai ki kaise anyway, it can be picked up in the earlier stages, or?
Earlier stages, there's no good way. I mean, if patient is developing unusual symptoms, like I said, imaging needs to be done sooner than later. If in future routine scans show survival benefit, that routine scans make patients live longer, then I'm sure those will get approved, but not at this time. The problem is, if once cancer spreads to the brain from other part of the body, it's not a good scenario. I mean, there are treatment options available, but so far routine screening has not shown to increase the life expectancy of the patients.
So what is the treatment, particular treatments for this type of cancer?
So it depends on the subtype and grade of the of the brain cancer. Surgery is the best treatment modality for primary brain cancers. If possible, the surgeon should be able to remove as much brain cancer as possible. The problem is, since brain controls so many vital organs of the body, in many situations, surgeon cannot resect the whole tumor because, let's say, if the cancer is involving a motor part of the brain area, then patient may lose
motor function
of one side of the body completely. I mean, it can happen. So
is it more like being paralyzed then?
Yes, that's possible. So surgeons try to remove as much cancer as possible. Ideal situation is, or ideal scenario is, whole tumor can be taken out if possible. If not, at least surgeons can perform a biopsy. And if the whole tumor cannot be removed, then there are other treatment options available after the surgery, which could include radiation with or without chemotherapy. So that depends on the subtype. If it's a low-grade brain cancer and whole tumor is taken out surgically, if it's possible, then usually no further treatment is offered. Either radiation or chemo is not offered. But in a little bit more aggressive tumors, either radiation with or without, some chemotherapy is an option. If it's a more aggressive, like I was talking about, grade 4 GBM, then we give radiation and chemo after the surgery. That's a routine for that particular cancer.
So like you said, that there's surgeries that, and sometimes surgeries, the surgeons are not able to take off the entire tumor. So maybe bits and parts are kind of still let there because you cannot touch it, because motor functionality could be just like it could be maybe loss of vision. It could affect anywhere, depends on where it is placed. Lekin to agar khuda na khasta aise kuch ho jata hai kisi ke saath, then a part of it is to be left. What is the chances of it growing more? What are the chances?
There is a good chance that it may regrow, and that's why these patients require further treatment, including radiation with or without chemotherapy. So there is a fair chance it will regrow. The five-year survival, when we talk about survival, it depends on the type of cancer.
Right.
For example, GBM doesn't have a good outcome, but some other subtypes can have up to 80-85% five-year survival. So that depends on the type of cancer, the grade, and also if neurosurgeon is able to remove the whole cancer or the tumor from the brain or not. Sometimes even, you know, at the time of surgeries, surgeons can leave chemotherapy impregnated wafers, like a small discs in the resection cavity. After removing the tumor, they can leave some chemotherapy impregnated small discs, and those can control cancer for a very long time as well.
That really sounded so high tech when you said that. Cake disc under, jo hai, they let it stay there so that it can fight with the
residual cancer cells.
Exactly. And anything else, jiske baare mein you want to add about the treatment, about the kya expect kiye jaye agar khuda na khasta somebody has to face this kind of cancer?
You know, the prognosis, of course, needs to be discussed with the oncologist, but, you know, every patient is different. What I suggest, if it can, brain cancer is diagnosed, try as much standard treatment as possible. Do not delay. Do not delay the treatment, because cancer, brain cancer, like I said, because it's enclosed cavity, the symptoms can progress quite rapidly, and it can be fatal quite rapidly. So do not delay the treatment. And whatever is the recommended treatment, get the full treatment.
Like I even read that if you're detected with brain cancer, it says death on diagnosis. How true is that about it?
Not always. Yeah, I mean, like I said, there are so many factors that determine the outcomes. And in some
That's
of these
right.
primary brain tumors, even patients can live a really long lifespan. You know, if it's one of those slow growing and, you know, the brain cancer, and if the whole cancer can be taken out at the time of surgery, and if there is any further recommended treatment after surgery, if patients follow all that regimen, then, you know, the survival can be up to 80-90% depending on the subtype and grade of the cancer.
Yeah, that so depending on the type of the cancer, there are a good 80-90% survival chances. And bahut zyada information aapne di hai. If you would like to add something else, aap add kar sakte hai. And you know, thank you for all this information about.
You're welcome. And I would say, you know, again, if there is any unusual symptom, get and seek medical attention as soon as possible. Don't delay the unusual symptoms. I mean, if they're mild symptoms, most of the times get better. But any mild symptoms or progressively getting, if the symptoms are progressively getting worse, those need to be dealt with as soon as possible.
All right. Thank you so much, Dr. Shumail, for all this information. Ye the Dr. Shumail jo har week hamare liye kuch na kuch information lekar aate hain on different types of cancer, kis tarah se unhe screen kiya jaye, kis tarah se treatment options available hai, and all the necessary information, basic information that we need to deal with different types of cancer. Chalte hain ek chote se break ki taraf, aur break ke us par hum baat karenge Lukman sahab se from Chase World Travel.